Lord, I need understanding in my marriage. How could he have done this to me? How could he have abandoned me? How could he forget his promises? How could he throw away in a moment all the things we have built? How could he break my heart? He said he wouldn't hurt me like the others. He promised. I do not understand how all these things can be happening right now. I do not understand how something can suddenly end up the way it is today. In the beginning, he said I was a gift from God given to him. We shared so many things commonly and emotionally. It is with him that I opened up my heart. It is with him that I found love again. How can he betray our covenant of marriage? It seemed not so long ago when we shared our poetry together, to read them out loud to one another. It wasn't long ago when he was in pain from the issues that happened in California. And I soothed him through you, my Lord and Savior. I was certain that it would last forever, like the million stars in the sky. Can our marriage be lost in an instant like a star disappearing in the night? I believed him forever. Now I don't know about anything anymore. I am so broken deep within myself, Lord. My heart is shattered along with my spirit that I don't know if I can put myself together. I have fallen, Lord. Please help me stand up. I feel so abandoned and hurt that I couldn't do anything to save myself of this kind of pain and suffering. What did I do to deserve this pain? No one deserves this kind of heartbreak. No one, Lord. Do I not deserve true love, loyalty, sincerity, compassion, and respect? Lord, can't you see he is not keeping your commandments concerning the covenant of marriage by denying my emotional needs, verbally or mentally, especially when I need him the most in sickness and in health? I know, Lord, he's doing this with the intent to inflict pain in my heart as a means of punishment, in which I don't have a clue as to why. In your presence, Lord, we signed papers offering our solemn vows to be faithful in sickness and in health, in good and bad times, and in joy as well as in sorrow. I promise to love unconditionally, to support each other in our goals, to honor and respect, to laugh with and cry, and to cherish each other for as long as we both shall live. I ask without understanding, Lord, isn't he supposed to honor and respect me as his wife? In Genesis 3:9, it is explained, with no answer, as he were hiding as Adam did from God. Lord, I know Satan hates the idea you created this covenant of marriage. So he coerced Eve to eat the forbidden fruit. Adam did not protect his wife. He let it all happen. He did not partake in his responsibility. After his downfall into sin of omission, instead of taking responsibility for his actions, he blames God and his wife. His wife blames the devil. Marriage is a covenant for reasons understandable. Satan hates all godly covenant relationships. In these feelings, Lord, I feel I'm not being protected either by my husband. Doesn't my husband know a husband and wife who have harmony with one another have power in prayer in defeating Satan? If anyone knows me, Lord, is you. You know that I am not one to hate, but love to love and loyal to my marriage. Because of this, Lord, I have lost my way. My invalidations are reality. My feelings right now are overwhelming, and I question myself and mistrust my own perceptions at this point. I have lost confidence in myself once again. I feel so bad because I have gone through this once before, Lord, and didn't think I would survive of it, and know that you are aware of my past hurt. Yes, I can say that my husband has helped me find my self-esteem because of the previous hurt. by things we love to do together and share with one another. But now he is trampling upon our marriage as though it were trash. How can he not feel guilty for what he is doing? How can he suddenly forget how I was there for him, standing by his side when he was going through his hurt and pain? How I wiped the sweat off his face. How I held him next to me. He forgot all about that. But then yet, he abandons our marriage because of his selfishness. Please help me, Lord. I really don't know what to do. Only your words can comfort me. Only your embrace can soothe my pain. I have given everything I could, my Lord, and there is nothing more I can give. I'm very exhausted. As I lay in my bed, as I did in my mother's womb, I kneel before you now, my Lord, crushed and broken, empty and afraid to be alone. Hold me in your loving arms. Hide me under your angel's wings. Please tell me again how much you love me. Please say unto me that you have called me yours and you will never ever let me go. Though men in my life have failed me, I know you remain faithful, steadfast, and immovable as a rock. Though many may judge me for the faults they see in me, Lord, you see my true heart and reveal to me how beautiful my soul is. Help me to let go of my pain. Teach me to forgive those who do not even ask for my forgiveness. This is such a burden in my heart and is something I shouldn't carry. This trouble is not something I should trade away my peace for. I know I have done wrong in my past, and I have your forgiveness. There are unjustly things in my life that have happened are not of my doing. It is so unfair. Let me not continue being unfair to myself by not letting go of the past. Let me not punish myself anymore for the things others have done or are doing presently. In this, Lord, I offer unto you my wounded heart, my broken heart, my shattered heart, and my broken spirit. I know it is you, my Lord, who will uphold me in the end. Let me not lose hope. Let me not cast away everything that's good and beautiful in this life. I know you have a plan for me, Lord. I know how much love I can still give because it is you who fills me with everything that I'll ever need. You are the one who loves me truly, internally, and unconditionally. You are the one who has always been there for me and always will be there for me. You are my one true love. You are my forever. You are my strength, my peace, my joy. In your presence, Lord, I will trust in you.